Now, here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Ford after it reached a tentative contract agreement with the United Auto Workers that may pave the way to ending their nearly six-week strike. Ford shares are up over 2% before the bell. Also in focus, shares of Standard Chartered as the bank's big bet on China hit a stumbling block, leading to significant losses in the country. The stock plummeted nearly 10%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Unilever after its CEO laid out long-awaited plans to simplify the business. The plans, though, failed to excite investors, sending Unilever shares down nearly 3% in midday trading. Asian markets ended Thursday trade in the red. The sell-off was led by tech stocks after a rout on Wall Street overnight. This dragged the tech-heavy KOSPI index to its lowest level in 9 months, even as South Korea reported better-than-expected third-quarter growth at 0.6%. Australia's ASX 200, meanwhile, fell to a one-year low. As for the Shanghai Composite, it bucked the downswing a day after China announced measures to boost its shaky economic recovery. Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of SK Hynix slumped nearly 6%. That's after the world's second biggest memory chip maker reported a 1.8 trillion won operating loss, which missed estimates by a hair. Meanwhile, shares of Leapmotor reversed course to tumble nearly 11% Thursday. The stock earlier rose on news Netherlands-based Stellantis is buying a 21% stake in the electric vehicle maker in a $1.6 billion deal. Here at home, Philippine shares joined the broader sell-off with the main index barely clinging to the 6,000 level.
Well, when we broke below the 6,000 level earlier, I think some stop loss were hit. That's why you probably saw some accelerated selling during the day. But I think we are now trading at oversold conditions in the short term, and we could bounce here in the next day or probably by the shortened week next week. I guess a lot of traders are also liquidating some positions because they're afraid of the long weekend. But I expect the market to, you know, bounce back a bit from here after the long holiday.
The Philippine Central Bank delivers an off-cycle rate hike in a bid to tame inflation. The BSP raised its benchmark rate by 25 basis points to 4.25% on Thursday after leaving it unchanged for the past three policy meetings. BSP Governor Eli Remolona calls the move urgent as latest projections point to an elevated inflation path. The bank also adjusted its 2024 inflation forecast to 4.7% from an earlier 4.3%. Transport costs, electricity rates, and wage adjustments are seen as upside risks. Remolona admits the BSP should have tightened its monetary policy earlier.
I think we fell a little bit behind. That's the reason for this effort to catch up. About 92% of consumers think that in the next 12 months, inflation will be above 4%. It's similar for expectations by firms. That's very worrisome to us because, as you know, monetary policy cannot control supply-side price shocks, but it can serve to break the link between those supply-side shocks and expectations.
Remolona also asserts the BSP's tightening has not affected economic growth as feared by the country's chief economist, Arsenio Balisacat. In fact, Remolona says they will consider another rate hike during their November 16 policy meeting if things are, quote, worse than we thought.
The Monetary Board is closely monitoring the impact of the increased interest rates as these work their way through the economy. The Monetary Board also continues to support fiscal efforts to sustain growth through more rapid program spending, as well as non-monetary interventions to address persistent supply-side pressures.